Hey there, Commanders, Commander Etz, Chesty Puller here with a video for Operation Isolation. This is the Eastern Horde 65, and this is not too bad. What you want to do is come in and knock the two towers out, and then after that, bring a Sheila in and a couple of javelins and your cyclones, and that's all you really need for this base. You'll notice I'm surrounding the bases, but we have hackers. Thanks, Kixi, for that. And they're trying to steal the bases, so we're trying to make it difficult. Strategically, try to click on both towers. Try to click on this tower and then the other tower that I'm keeping just on the edge of my screen. Okay, this is amazing lag here. Let's see if the lag will go away. And we can deal with the lag. We just need to get rid of the hackers. So after the towers are taken out, you can come in with a Sheila and a couple of javelins. I use four javelins. My Sheila, of course, has a Barz rifle. And again, a lot of this stuff is, you just don't go full forward. You'll notice I'm pausing, I'm waiting for just the right time. I'm trying to draw things out, so I wanted to get that operator, then get this operator, and then get this third operator. If you do it wrong and they all come out at the same time, then you know you're going to be screwed. So then notice that there is a firebomb up there, so I can't go too far. Also, this is real close. I was a little bit worried when those other two went over on the other side, and I don't know why they did, but they went into the range of that drone silo, so be careful. Just, you know, if you see them heading over there, back them up. Don't end attack, because that drone silo is filled with night owls, and they will. I mean, you've seen what they've done to people's special forces. What do you think they'll do to my javelins? My javelins will be gone in 1 second. And I can't afford that. With as little space as Kixi has given us lately, I literally have, I think, 8 javelins total. I have 4 in 2 separate platoons, and that's it. So when I lose my javelins, the only reason I think I have them separated is because if I lose them, then you know, there's a lot of things I can't do without javelins. So they're an important part of the game, but they are extremely weak. The name of the game there is don't get shot. And let's see here. Normally I go up and I take care of that hunter and that, it just seemed like everything was down here, so I'm gonna change it up. I kind of play by the seat of my pants because I don't have a specific thing that I do every single time. I just have a general strategy. And what I was trying to do right there was to draw that Ultra Tank out, but obviously he wasn't having any of that. So now what I'm going to do is I want to take out the... And you notice how I was hovering over end attack in case that hunter targeted me, because I'm kind of at the wrong angle there. You don't give enough space on that side of the base. Now I'm using 2 separate platoons here. One to shock the Ultra, and the other to stun the operator. It worked out well. You know, you have to have... It's all about timing strategy, really. So I had a choice there to take out the drone silo first. I didn't really want to do it because there's a hunter over there, and once he targets you, you only have a nanosecond before he shoots, and I think that he targeted me. So that's why I chose to take a hit from the drone silo rather than chance that hunter over there. Like I said, normally I come up this way first and take out the hunter, and then I wouldn't have had to worry about that, and then I can come right over here and get that drone silo and not take a hit. So that's the reason I probably come up this way first. Now, you also have to play it careful here. Again, like I said, your javelins really can't take a hit. So those, even the hover would mess my javelins up. So one thing I found is that in these event bases, they have, I believe these are level 20 Banshees, and they are pretty beefy. They take a lot of hits. My Banshees my Banshees are level 20, but not fully promoted yet. And I don't think my Banshees take that kind of a hit. And but that's it's pretty, actually pretty impressive what these Banshees, the amount of hits that they take. Just to make things a little bit easier, you know, I could have come in there and taken pretty much everything out with my Cyclones. However, I just figured I'd break that Ultra Tank out. It's there, we might as well use it. And I am giving this base away, so I'm not going to fully clear it, but I'm going to clear all defenders and then all useless buildings. I'm just going to leave the res for whoever gets this base. And that's pretty much it. I do hope that this was helpful. And like I said, Tier A is got some hard bases in it. And fortunately, Kixeye has made it a little bit more reasonable so that, say, 38, 39, 40s can start doing Tier A. One of the main complaints I have with this game is that, for instance, this event, I am further behind now, I think, than I have been in years. Look at the amount of things that they have. For instance, 500, 600, 700, 800,000. You know, the Tempest limited tech is 500,000, so I can only get one or two of those things. It's ridiculous.